All right, hello and assalamu alaikum and a very good evening. I would like to thank the people who are available for today's online lesson. Today's lesson will be based on the speaking skill. So let me just like share my screen first and have you have access to the materials that I would like to share with you today. Okay, I'm pretty sure that we have had a look at this particular page here. So my objective for today is basically for you to engage in a speaking session with me, especially with regards to this particular topic here, which is regarding films. Okay. I'm pretty sure that you are aware that we have film reviews that you should be writing, especially during examinations. There might be films that you have to write about. Sometimes questions regarding films also appear on your speaking exam questions, so probably it's worth looking at. Okay, so I think I'll start off with this particular very simple question here. If you were to describe your favorite film in one word only, can you please get me a word that you can describe your film that you really like in the chat? Can you type in the chat right now? How would you describe the best film that you like? Okay, so you can have that typed in the chat. Just give me like one word before we look at the possibilities in terms of, what words can you use to describe your best film. Okay, once you have written, probably I'll ask verbally the word that you have selected for your favorite film. Okay, how much time do you need? So I'll give you like around 5 seconds, maybe. I don't think we need that much time for you to describe your best film. Can we have it written in the chat? How would you describe your best film? Probably, I'll give an example first. Maybe I'll describe it as amazing. Okay, so let me know what words you would like to select for your favorite film. Okay. Adam has given us the word phenomenal in the chat. Adam, do you mind telling me what the film is? What film is it that you have described as phenomenal?
The film is Harry Potter film.
Oh, you're an avid reader of the Harry Potter series as well.
Yes, I am.
Between the film and the book, which one do you feel is much more phenomenal? The word that you've used just now was phenomenal. So, which one is more phenomenal?
To be honest, it's the book, of course. It's more, it's more detailed on some point.
Okay, so do you feel like the actual film has not been able to portray all the details in the book? Can you like tell us like what details are missing in the film for people who haven't read the book yet?
I guess on the last battle, actually Draco Malfoy helped Harry instead throwing Harry's wand at Harry. In the movie, there is not that scene. There isn't that scene, but the book, it's there. But
Ah. Okay. So, if you would recommend, which one would you recommend more, the book or the film?
I think I would recommend the movie first, and then if you fall in love with that movie, then I'll recommend the books.
Oh, why is that the case?
I guess the movie is more can attract more people, and it's not.
How do you say it attracts more people because of how it looks, the cinematography and so on. So how do you say that? Is that a phrase that you can use to show that it looks good on screen?
I catch him.
Eye catching?
I catch him.
Ah, okay, eye catching. Okay,
You.
so probably if I could just, okay, you can still see my screen, right? Can you
Yes,
see?
I see.
Okay, all right. So probably what I can share with you, since Adam has mentioned the word eye catching, and he's saying that maybe people should watch the film first, due to the fact that they might be attracted to how it looks. Okay, so another way of saying, okay, let me just, I believe you can see my screen right now. Okay, so Adam has used the word phenomenal here. Okay, this is an example that I've shown you already before of my students' film review. So the word phenomenal was used by Adam just now. And probably if you want to say that the visuals are good, probably you can also say the visuals are stunning. And there's another phrase that you can use, which is visually appealing. Have you used that before? Visually appealing. What does that mean? It looks... Okay, so probably what we can do right now is we can have a look at the term first. And then probably after this, if you want to use it in your essay or in your film review, you can do that. Okay. Can you see the dictionary on your screen right now?
Yes.
Yep. Okay. So visually appealing here means that it looks good on the screen. The visuals are convincing. The visuals are beautiful. Okay. Most probably because of the cinematography, or maybe there are some, CGI. What does that mean? Do you know? CGI?
Computer generated interface.
Ah, okay. So probably there might be computer generated, like Avatar. Have you watched Avatar before? Can you see?
Yes.
Yeah. So it looks real, and it's probably visually appealing because of the scenes that you see on the screen compared to reading a book. Because when you're reading a book, you're just looking at words. But of course, I'm pretty sure that, you know, people like Adam, you can see that, you know, reading a book is also very satisfying, and there are reasons for that as well. Okay, thank you for responding to the question that I've given. Okay, so right now, I think that probably it's worth for us to have a look at some examples of film genres first. Okay, can you tell me some of the genres that you know? So, okay, let me just
action,
ask.
Action, thriller.
Okay, so that's Vaitis or Tineshto? Who's that?
Vaitis.
Okay, so we've got action, thriller. Okay. Right now, horror. Maybe horror. Yeah, we've got horror. Okay, if I could just like show you on the screen right now. Okay, I've got a few movie genres here. Okay, let's say you're looking at this person. Can you see some faces on the screen right now?
Yeah,
yes.
Okay. There aren't any numbers, but probably on your left right now, we've got this man sipping on his drink. What movie do you think he's watching? Can I ask? Okay, I'll just nominate right now. Let's ask Dinesh first, maybe?
Sure.
What genre do you think he's watching?
I think he's watching a thrilling film.
A thriller?
Yes.
Okay, why does he look like he's watching a thriller? Can you describe his face first, if you can do that? He looks like... Is he excited?
Like wide open.
His eyes are wide open, okay.
And one more thing I also noticed about his face, he's like very like obnoxious.
Can you what was the word that you used just now?
Obnoxious.
Can we have it spelled? What does it mean?
He's like I'm saying is it like very eager with himself?
Okay, so he looks very eager. So you're guessing that he is watching a thriller. Can you give me an example of a thriller that probably you would like to recommend?
I would probably recommend watching the latest movie that just came out.
What is that? What's the title?
Jurassic Park Dominion.
Ah, so the genre is thriller for Jurassic Park.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why do people enjoy watching thrillers, do you think?
I think they would prefer watching thriller movies because in the, because they get to feel the excitement in their body, and in the same time they get to enjoy watching the fantastic scene from the movie itself, and also get to release their nervousness while watching thriller movies. I remember when I watched Jurassic World Dominion, I learned that multiple people in the cinema, they were very hyped up, and they were like very, it was just like an uproar in the cinema as well when they saw this movie.
And there was an uproar in the cinema.
Yeah, because so it was very loud. And also they were like full, and they were like joyful as well.
Mm-hmm. So based on your description just now, we can definitely understand why people watch thriller, despite the fact that it could sometimes give you a jump scare. Okay, the rest of you, have you heard of the word jump scare before?
Yes, I heard it before.
What does it mean?
It means like something that you didn't expect it to happen.
Mm-hmm.
And you got scared from out of nowhere.
Yeah, out of nowhere. So I guess that's part of the reason why people do watch thriller, to experience that jump scare there. Although some people may not like it, but you know, apparently there are people who enjoy having jump scares. All right, so okay, we can move to another cinema goer. These people who are watching cinema, they are called cinema goers, but I don't know if you have another word for it that you can give me other than cinema goers, film goers. What other words would you describe or probably use for people who go and watch the cinema? People who love watching the cinema.
Viewers, spectators.
You can say viewers for people who watch films and, you know, even on television. But there's a specific term that you can use.
Cinephile.
Okay, so what was the word again?
Cinephile or cinephile.
Cinephile. Okay, let's just check the spelling. Do you know the spelling? Can we get the spelling?
I-L-E. Yeah.
Okay, so that's Cinephile, right? Okay, Cinephile. Okay, so if you could use this in your film review or, you know, in your speaking, other than saying cinema goers, you can also use the word cinephile, because if we do look at the definition, can you see the definition on the screen right now? Is it on your screen?
Yes.
Okay, a person who is fond of the cinema. Okay, just for vocabulary drilling right now, how else would you say being fond of something? Fond of. A person who loves the cinema, a person who, what else? What other words can you use for fond of?
Zealous.
Zealous? Okay, so I've got the word zealous just now. Who gave that word?
Amir.
Okay. So Amir gave us the word zealous. Okay. The pronunciation is zealous. Of course, you can use it in your essay if you want to. So having a lot of passion for something. Okay. So if you say that a person has a lot of passion for cinemas, you can also say that the person shows a lot of zeal, or the person is zealous about cinemas. And other words that you can use, just like we've discussed just now, cinema goers, cinephile. Okay, so the main purpose of me doing this particular lesson for today is to increase our vocabulary, just do a bit of revision on what you have already learned, and you know, for the purpose of you speaking about your favorite film, so that after this you can write about your favorite film. All right, done. Okay, I think I can go to one more genre, because just now it was a thriller genre that Teenage has very elaborately spoken about. Can I get between the person who's wiping his tears here and then the person who looks like he's very, very much terrified, and this particular person who's laughing, which facial expression do you usually have when you watch your favorite film? Can I have one person respond? Anyone?
I think the laughing one.
The laughing one. So this is Amir, is it?
Vitis.
Vitis. Okay. So Vitis, you love watching comedies? Is that the genre you're talking about?
Yes.
Okay, so why would a comedy entertain you?
Because comedy films are usually like they are like enjoying, you know. It can make your it can make ourselves be enjoyed and stress relieving and like.
Do you have like a proverb that you can use to express how laughing can make you feel better? Is there a proverb that we can use? For example, people usually say laughter is the best. What? Can you continue my sentence? Laughter is the best. Can you see it on the screen right now? Do you agree with this, Vitis? Laughter is the best medicine.
Yes, I agree with that.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Like, it can relieve your stress. It can relieve your body tension. It can make you feel calm, relaxed.
Mm-hmm. Would you like to share with us like a title of a film that makes you feel that way? Or are you going to refer to drama series like Friends? Or is that like too old? Do you have other comedies?
I think Friends is too old. Yeah. I can say that Boys Meet the World.
Boys Be the World. Is that like a film or a drama? Is it a film or a drama, Vitis?
It's a series, Boys Meet the World.
Oh, okay. So it's a drama series. Okay, so
and
I guess
when it comes to movie, I think Bullet Train.
Bullet Train. Okay. Yeah. So let's say what do you like best about Bullet Train there? And how, what is the sense of humor like? Is it extremely funny?
It's not extremely funny, it's like a dark humor, you know.
Oh, dark humor. Out of my own curiosity, can you just like explain like what do you mean by dark humor?
Dark humor is usually referring to we are making jokes on like a serious thing, we make it as a joke. Like
I think you use
if
one
we take an example. Uh-huh. If we see someone is getting beaten by
someone is beaten by some what? Okay, do we still have Vitis on the line just now?
Yes. Yeah.
Someone is beaten by what?
Okay, if take an example, if someone is beaten by someone, then mm-hmm. We make it as a joke. That's what is called dark humor.
Okay. So something serious, you turn it into a joke so that people don't take it too seriously.
Yes.
Okay.
Sometimes it's dangerous too.
Yeah, it could be dangerous for the people. Making things look like hilarious even though it's not. Okay, so another word for funny or you know what Vitis is mentioning just now would be hilarious. Okay, a sense of humor, those are referring to being funny. Okay, thank you. So another one that he's used just now was dark humor. I'm very intrigued by the term dark humor because you know it's something contrasting. Okay. But never mind, if you do feel like you want to include that in your film review, explain why the dark humor entertains you. Okay, so another phrase that we've used just now was laughter is the best medicine. Okay, so I hope that you're jotting it down so that after this, if I do ask you to give me like sentences and responses, you can recycle, use it back. Okay, so right now, probably I think that should be enough for the genres that we have. I think we can go in much deeper sense for the genre. So let's try another activity that I have prepared here. Okay, so I've got a few genres that probably I can share with you on the screen right now. Okay, so these are posters that have been made by, you know, my Form 3 students. But just can we just have a guess as to what the genre on the left is? Can you see it on the screen right now? What would be the genre for this Spider-Man Far From Home?
Action.
Action. Do we have any adventure? Okay. Do you think that it's fiction or non-fiction?
Non-fiction.
Non-fiction, because there might be some things which are unrealistic. Okay, so this one would probably be fantasy, adventure, genre, action.
Sci-fi.
Okay? Sci-fi, definitely. Science fiction as well. Okay, how about the one on the left? Sorry, on the right. What genre would this be?
Psycho thriller.
Psycho thriller? Psychological thriller. Okay, so probably this one, because you can see like this is an evil orphan. I don't know whether you've watched The Orphan before. Can I just have a show of hands? Who has watched The Orphan before? The Orphan. Have you watched it on Netflix before? Not yet. Okay, so just in case you have watched it, it is a psychological thriller. There is a difference, I guess, between a real thriller or horror film and a psychological thriller. Psychological thrillers don't really have any ghosts or any, you know, real murderers, but rather they just use like simple characters, like a young girl. But then again, the young girl's actions are the ones that make it very thrilling for you to watch. Okay, so I think what I need you to do, okay, can we try and engage in a conversation? I'm giving you some words or phrases that you can use, okay? So let's say one person wants to watch The Evil Orphan just now, okay? So you're going to say, I think we should watch a psychological thriller because, so the words that I would like you to use would be words like unpredictable, jump scare, and thrilling. So far, can you see the words on the screen right now? Do you see the words on the screen?
Yes.
Yep. Okay, so I need you to try and be with another person and just discuss which film are you going to watch. So what I need from you, the aim of doing this is for you to think of the characteristics of the film, what's good about it, and why you would recommend it to your friend so that you can convince your friend to watch it. Okay. Another genre just now was the science fiction, Spider-Man Far From Home just now that you saw. So that one was an adventure genre. So you can use words like futuristic, so creative, and tell me about the plot. You can make reference to the actual Spider-Man film. And tell us whether the plot is interesting enough. Okay, anyone who would like to try? Otherwise, of course, I have to nominate. So one person is going to try and convince your friend to watch The Evil Orphan just now. And another person is going to convince your friend to watch the Spider-Man Far From Home just now. Do we have any volunteers? Okay, so who do I have in the session? I think we might want to hear from girls as well. And I think I can just like pair you up with a boy. Can we have any volunteers before I nominate anyone? Okay, let's try and have... okay, Vitis has spoken. Adam has spoken just now. So can we get Emir? You haven't spoken fully yet. And probably I can have Emir talking with Intan, maybe? Would that be okay? Is your microphone okay?
Yes.
So, okay, who gets to select first? Emir, if you are selecting a film, which one would you select?
I need to choose between this story or something else?
Based on this. Or maybe at least take the genre, at least refer to the genre. Would it be a science fiction or a psychological thriller? for your own preference?
I think I much prefer to choose science fiction.
Okay, so Amber is going to take science fiction. So I need you to select words on your right. Is that okay?
Understood.
Okay, in 10, you have to try and convince us to watch a psychological thriller. Is your microphone okay?
Yes, it is.
All right. Okay, so who's going to speak first? Can we have ladies first, I guess? Ladies first. Intan, you have to make sure that Amir wants to follow you to the cinema and watch a psychological thriller. What would you say?
Do I have to use the sentence that?
Yeah, if you want to, and then make sure that you use the words that I'm putting on the screen right now. Of course, you can add on to it. Can you just like say hi, like in a speaking situation? Hi, Amir. I think we should watch. Can you start with that?
Okay.
Okay, 1, 2.
Hi, Amir. I think we should watch a psychological thriller film because in my opinion, the storyline would be unpredictable because we can see that how someone
or do you mean like the character, the main character,
how the character always just like what Titi said before, like how she has
what is it that you want to say? Like the character has what? Is it, can you like predict the actions that the character will do next, usually in a psychological thriller?
No, maybe what? Maybe we expect the character to do something, but it turns out she actually, the twist is actually the key point in this kind of genre.
So you're saying that a psychological thriller has some sort of a plot twist that is very interesting for viewers.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How about the fact that there might be some jump scares as well? Have you experienced watching that before?
For the jump scare, I think it's not the same with the horror jump scare.
Mm-hmm.
It's more like
what? Do you need like a ghost, like a very, you know, terrifying face on the screen usually for psychological thrillers?
No, I don't think so. Because for psychological thriller, the jump scare is more to like the how the character evolves.
How the character what?
Wait.
How the character?
How the character develop the.
How the character is somehow like evolving. Is that what you're saying? From one particular side of the character, somehow you see a split personality, for example. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's why you would recommend this particular genre.
Yeah.
Is it thrilling enough, do you think, for Emir to watch?
Since Emir like, you know, the sci-fi, mm-hmm. I think it should be training enough for him to watch this as well, because mm-hmm. the just like the movie that you may choose, it also has the thrill genre in the film itself. So I think, in so I think you may should watch the psychological thriller film so that he can feel the difference between the sci-fi thrill and the psychological thrill.
There's a difference in terms of the type of thrill that you get by watching both films. Yes. Okay, thank you to Intan there. Another phrase that you can use to say that something is thrilling would also be related to hormones. Like, can you give me like a phrase? Any one of you definitely can respond. Is there a phrase that to show that, you know, it gets you excited?
The adrenaline rush.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we've got adrenaline rushing. So you can say that the psychological thriller gets your adrenaline rushing as well as you watch it at the cinema. Okay, thank you. So that was by Intan. Amir, are you ready to convince Intan that, hey, we should watch science fiction instead? What would you say?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, but probably it's a bit distant. I don't know why.
How about now?
Okay, let's try it.
Okay. Hello, Intan. I have another film dinner that I think is good for us to watch at the cinema. And I think it is Spider-Man Far From Home.
Mm-hmm.
The reason I was fascinated by this movie because
Fascinated. The reason why I was fascinated by this movie is because
I was fascinated by this movie because how the way this movie look cool and mind blowing, and how much effort does the director put, and how much effort does the director to put such a creative scenes. And at the end of this movie, there's a plot twist that starstruck me. That made me cloud nine. On cloud nine. And I think since Intan was a fan of a handsome actor, I think Tom Holland would be the best option for her.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I don't know whether everyone else could hear Emir very clearly, but I heard some phrases like mind-blowing, there's a plot twist, but probably because of the distant sound, it's not that clear. But okay, is there anything else, Emir, that you would like to add to the film genre?
I don't have any idea yet for the genre.
Okay. All right, thank you. So, probably you can add the use of the words of, like on the screen that you see right now, definitely a science fiction like Spider-Man would have very futuristic scenes because sometimes they are imagination only. You don't actually like have it happen in real life, which is why it is a science fiction. So, futuristic scenes. And then you did mention there is a plot twist. Okay, so thank you. So I don't know whether you have been able to convince Intan to watch a science fiction or not, but the use of the words just now was good enough. Okay, so just looking at the example that I have given to you before of the one that my previous student has done. Okay, if you do want to comment on a film, okay, there are some phrases that you could just like have it written down in your notes, and you could just add it into your review later when you write about it or speak about the film. So for example, you can say that if you want to say that it is unpredictable, you can say it is beyond my expectation. I did not expect it to be like that. Okay, so there are other phrases as well. You can mention the script. The script was well written. The acting was phenomenal. We discussed just now visually appealing or visuals are stunning. And if you want to talk about the storyline, you can say it was narratively satisfying. Okay, because narrative here is talking about the storyline. So if you say narratively satisfying, it gives you a lot of satisfaction. You're very satisfied with how it turned out. Okay, one more thing that I might want you to use would be an idiom. If you say that the director did a good job, okay, just now I think Amir did mention the director, managed to do a good job. You can also say the director knocked it right out of the park. Okay, the director managed to knock it right out of the park, which means that he managed to accurately or do it in the best manner possible. Okay, when he directed the film. Okay, so those would be among the phrases that you can use. So now I think we can have a look at how does a film review look like? And probably after this, okay, as a byproduct of this particular session, you can try and write about one film, okay? But for now, I think let's just try and review one film that has already been reviewed by one of your friends. If you remember last time, I asked you to produce a video on Padlet. So this is one of it. Okay, I'm selecting one here by Afika, I think. Afika Faizal. Okay, so probably we can go through this particular film review. And then let's just comment on some of the effects that you see on the anime. May I just have a show of hands? How many of you actually watch anime? Can you raise your hand using the feature on the... So let me see who raised their hands. Okay, so Sufi watches anime, Aina does, Fatia, Firdaus, Faiz, and that's it. Okay, so not that many of you watch anime. So if I could ask one of you, Faiz, why do you watch anime? Why don't you watch like films which have like real people acting? What's the fun thing about watching animes?
So I watch the anime because I like the the feeling when you watch the anime. If you watch an anime, and between the drama, you can see the different of the storyline between of both of them.
I would have to agree with you because sometimes animes really touch your heart in a way that normal films don't do that. So why do you think that is the case? Is it because they are from Japan or what? How do those people manage to like touch your heart so much? It's very heart-wrenching, if I could give you that word. Sometimes you feel so sad when you're watching animes. I do watch like one at least. But why is that the case? Can you see this on the screen right now? Heart-wrenching. Do you see it on the screen?
Yes, heart-wrenching. Okay. Extremely sad or distressing.
Why are animes sometimes, you know, it makes you really extremely sad or distressing? How do they do that? Can you share with us?
I need to process it. I think the anime has most heart-wrenching because of
would it be the script?
The script. The script of the anime are most better than the dramas or the K movies. Because of the
What do you want to say?
Mendalami. In English, what you should say that.
Okay, so you want to say that in the script writers have really, really carefully thought of it. Carefully thought of. That's one way. Of course, we have other ways of saying things, I think. Well thought of or carefully thought of, okay, meaning that dia telah really like did a lot of research. Is that what you want to say?
Yeah, having good reputation.
If something is well thought of, meaning like it is really looked at very in great detail, and probably because they have sat down and like really discussed the script in really great detail, and how do they make the audience sad and so on. So when something has been carefully thought of, that's the sort of effect that you get. Okay, so let's see whether this particular film gets you feeling sad in any way. And after this, I will definitely ask you further about why people watch anime instead of, you know, the normal films that we watch. Okay, so let me just try and I need to mute. Okay, so let me know if you cannot hear it. I'll try and ensure that. Okay, let me just like stop presenting first, and I'll try to present a video. Okay, I'll present a tab right now. Okay, you can see it on the screen, I believe.
Assalamualaikum and hi. My name is Nur Afika binti Faizal and I am from 4 Science. For today, I'm going to talk about a movie review. The movie I will talk about for today is Spirit Away. Spirit Away is a 2001 Japanese animated fantasy film written and directed by Hayao Miyazaki, animated by Studio Ghibli. This movie is an unforgettable, thrilling, enchanting anime movie. I was struck by a quality between love and generosity. The movie falls under the genre of animation, drama, and revolve around the themes of child's innocence, fearlessness, and pure love. This movie tells the story of Chihiro Ogino, a 10-year-old girl, and her parents end up at an abandoned amusement park inhabited by supernatural beings. She ended up into the world of kami, which is spirits of Japanese Shinto folklore. After her parents are turned into pigs when they eat foods prepared for all the god spirit by the witch Yubaba, Chihiro takes a job working in Yubaba's bathhouse to find a way to free herself and her parents and return to the human world. The characters move more than convincingly and the colors are indeed beautiful. Chihiro's strong will to help her parents and also her selflessness when she put others' needs over her own is just so stirring. The building of connections between Chihiro, Haku, Kaunashi, Bo, and also the Blackbird leads to forever affectionate bonds. The conclusion of the movie is as beautiful as the whole story, with Chihiro helping everyone in making their lives better, not only her friends, but also the witch who captured them. I definitely recommend this movie since Spirit Away has many lessons to learn, like the only way to get anywhere in life is to work hard. It was a catchy, full of suspense and humorous movie. How Chihiro chooses to react to the ever-changing circumstances around her, even the most horrifying ones, defines this movie's central moral.
Okay, I think I'll give you the full link, which has been by Afika. You can definitely watch it further once I get you the link. And it's actually on our Padlet, in which we collect all the reviews that you have made in the form of video. So based on the film review just now, were you able to hear Afika's review? Did you hear it?
No, I didn't.
Yeah?
Yes.
Amy, did you hear?
Yeah, yes. I could hear it.
Ah, okay. So it was, there wasn't any problem with the audio, eh? Okay. So based on the film that you have seen just now, reviewed by Afika just now, do you think that you would try watching anime after this if you're not an anime lover? Do you feel like it would be something you would like to watch after this in future? So let me ask, can I get a response from Pavitra? Did you manage to watch the review by Afika just now?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Do you suppose like an anime is something that you would like to watch in future after watching Afika's review?
I'm afraid that I won't like that.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Because I'm a person who like to see a person's acting more than a 2D acting.
Mm-hmm.
And also I like focus pictures more than a simple and simple or more to a visual that have more to a visual that didn't have any clarity.
Mm-hmm. Okay, in the defense of animes, would anyone like to defend animes? Probably, you know, having a different view compared to Pavitra just now, because Pavitra says that she might not want to watch anime because of the, it's only 2D effect. So what, can I have a response in the defense of animes maybe? Anyone who would like to say otherwise? Of course, that's Pavitra's preference. So we don't necessarily have to disagree with her, but just in case you feel like animes are actually good, why would you say it? Is Karim around? Has Karim entered the class? No. Are you there, Karim?
I'm here.
Okay. Would you be someone willing to try out watching anime, or are you actually an anime lover yourself?
I started watching Anime Lover a few years back, but now I quit it because anime nowadays contain many inappropriate subjects such as 18 plus and whatsoever. So I quit it.
Right. But I'm pretty sure that the one that Afika has reviewed just now did not contain that much of, you know, obscenity. So do you feel like the one that Afika has reviewed is worth watching, and why?
My sister actually forced me to watch the anime, so I have watched them before.
So what's the best thing about watching animes? How would you describe it?
I think the best thing about watching anime is with my family. I don't have anything else to say. It's just a story. It has many moral values, but that's it.
So you're saying that the best thing about the anime, I can see that from Afika's review that there are many moral values, and most of it are very distressing and makes you feel very sad because it relates to the parents, you know, and the hopelessness when something bad happens to your parents, and you have to try and be very selfless. So those are the moral values that you can get. Okay, thank you, Karim, for that response. Anyone else who would like to respond to the film review made by Afika? Do you think Afika has done a good job at reviewing the film? What were some of the words that you have learned from the review just now? So, for example, if you want to say the story is about, you don't necessarily have to say the story is about. You can use the phrase by Afika just now. The story revolves around a girl and her family, for example. So you can use phrases like revolves around. That's actually quite a lot. It's very dense in words or phrases that are suitable for film review. So I do encourage you to rewatch it and then jot down some of the words that she has used in her film review. Okay. All right. So that would be it for the film review by Afika. If you want to rewatch it, I think I can give you a link right now on Canva. You can take the link or you can refer to the video, the Padlet that we have made. Okay. Just in case you forgot about the link. Okay. Probably we can have a look at the link again. The one that I asked you to insert your reviews. Okay, so which one is it? Four Signs speaking videos, this one, eh? Okay, is it on your screen right now? Am I still sharing?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so we've got quite a few film reviews that you can refer to. We've got Afik Haikal film review. We've got Logis as well, a film review. Adam was didn't do a film review. Okay, Sufi did a film review. Haikal, okay. So you can actually like rewatch some of your friends' film reviews to get the words or phrases that they use. So for example, we watched Afika's film review just now. She used words which are very, very suitable to describe films. Okay, so you can definitely check hers out. Okay, we've also got, I think Vaitis also did a film review. Okay, so Zahira did one as well. So by referring to the reviews made by your friends, I think you can learn a lot of new vocabulary so that you can use and recycle the words in your review as well. Do remember, it's not just meant for writing only. Even in speaking, people can ask you about films, you know, the world of entertainment and so on. Okay, before we do end this lesson, I think we have like around 5 minutes. I am going to bring you to my material on Canva here. Okay, so I've got a few questions which are related to films that we can try and discuss so that we can get more words out for when you want to write your review or speak about films. So I've got one here. These are just some controversial issues which I just require your opinion on it. Okay, so my first question is, I myself am not really certain about whether DC is better than Marvel or not. But can I get any one of you to respond? Is DC better than Marvel? Okay, first, probably what you can do is, okay, raise your hands up if you think that DC is better than Marvel. Vitis raised his hand. Anyone else? I was educated, I think, by my own students previously, in which they explained what DC is and Marvel. Probably DC is a bit older than Marvel. DC would be characters like Superman, Batman, and Marvel would be the new ones, like Spider-Man, I guess, Iron Man. So which one is better? Can anyone respond? Who has raised their hands just now? Vitis. Okay. Tinesh disagrees, Vitis agrees. Let me hear from Vitis first, probably. Why do you say DC is better than Marvel?
Yes, I think DC is agree than DC is better than Marvel because these days Marvel movies CGI is not best that we can expect. That CGI, the camera quality are becoming so worse right now. Compared to DC right now, DC Cinematic Universe, they are improving right now. They are not like the old movies. If we take an example like Black Adam, Dex. Aquaman, like films like that are the turning point of DC.
So you're saying So you're saying that films like Aquaman, those would be among the best CGI that the entertainment industry could provide us?
Yes, I can say too. Like compared to new MCU movies, their CGI are becoming worse right now.
Ah, I wonder why. I thought I heard you mention in class that they're using top-notch cameras.
Yeah, top-notch camera qualities like that, action sequences.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Tinesh would like to disagree. What do you have to say, Tinesh?
I think personally Marvel is the best. It's the best film that people watch. Of course, like the movie Spider-Man No Way Home, Avengers Endgame, which I know millions and trillions of people watched it, and they also get to understand more about the movie on how far Marvel actually evolved.
Marvel has evolved a lot. Is that what you're saying?
Yes. Yes, and not even that. As the day gone past, they are now releasing more and more movies that are unique and even got the intentions of a lot of people.
So you're saying that because many people watch it, so there might be a possibility that, you know, it's actually better than DC.
Yeah. Yes. Oh. And not only that, they were also, after the actual movie came out, there will be animated as well, which I'm sure everyone will watch.
Mm-hmm. All right, thank you for that opinion. So I guess after this, Tinesh and, you know, Vitis can try and continue the conversation regarding which one is better, DC or Marvel, and probably come to a consensus, you know, come to an agreement. Yes. About which one is actually better. Do you think that you will ever come to a consensus about it?
No, because but actually I think that MCU was better when the release of No Way Home. No Way Home.
Spider-Man No Way Home. So it got better then.
Like after the release of No Way Home, I think the MCU is ruined.
Okay, so you
fans are like roasting the whole MCU. If I go any social media account, social media websites, the whole fans are roasting MCU, like telling the CGI, and even experience it.
Okay, so people may have different points of views regarding, you know, which one is better, but I guess we might have to like listen to the experts regarding CGI, for example, in order, because we are looking, you know, from the naked eye without really, you know, understanding a lot about CGI and so on. So probably you might want to have comments made by the experts and see what they think as well. You might want to watch read the reviews from there as well. Okay, so it's already 9 p.m. Of course, I've got other questions that I might want to ask you. For example, okay, probably I can try like one more before I end this session. This one is probably an easy one. Watching films at the cinema is a waste of money. This might be worth thinking about, so that probably if you get the words and phrases regarding films and how good cinemas are, you can insert that in your review or your speaking session later. So who would agree that watching films at the cinema is a waste of money? You can raise your hand. Maybe you can think that Netflix is better rather than going to the cinema. So who'd like to respond to this particular statement here? Is it a waste of money? Okay, I think I'll have my last person to speak. Let's just have like one random person. Afiq Haikal, maybe? Do you have a thought on this?
No.
No? And you would not even want to try? Do you watch films at the cinema?
Yes, lots of times.
Okay, so would you recommend it? Do you think it's a waste of money? No. Is that what you're saying?
No, because we can enjoy our environment by watching things in cinema.
Can you explain that? What sort of environment are you talking about?
We can hear the sound effect beside our ears, and we can enjoy the screen from.
Yeah, it's the largest screen that you have. Yeah,
largest screen. Yes. So for 2 hours, we can't. It won't waste our money as we. It is satisfied.
Satisfying.
It is satisfying.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I would have to agree with you. I wouldn't say that it is a waste of money, although there might be people who can actually like just wait for the release on Netflix, for example, like Mark Kilau just now, last time. I didn't even go to the cinema. We waited for it to be released on Netflix, but I'm pretty sure that the feeling would not be the same. Like what Afiq has said just now, the environment is probably different. So definitely agree with you there. Okay, so I guess that's the end of our session for today. I'll definitely want you to check out your Delima platform, because I have attached some of the materials that I've shown to you just now, like the Form 4 textbook about the film just now, as well as the transcript by my own student who has written about the film review. So do check out your Delima platform for some of the materials that I've attached. Okay, I think we have had a very fruitful discussion for tonight. Thank you for joining the session, and I hope that after this session you have more words to use in your film review as well as in your speaking. Okay, thank you. But before you leave, can I have 5 new words that you learned for today? Vaitis, 5 new words that you learned for today? Any words that have captured your attention?
No, teacher, I think just one phenomenon.
Come again?
I guess only one.
One word. What was the word?
Phenomenon.
Come again?
Phenomenon.
Phenomenal.
Phenomenal, yeah.
Phenomenal. Okay, phenomenal. So Vaitis has learned the word phenomenal. One more person, I think, before we end this session. Can I get one person to tell me 5 words at least that are new to you? Can we have Tisham? Any new words that you have learned for today? Do we have Tisham? Okay, Tisham is probably still thinking. Do we have Tisham?
Can I go?
Okay, Tinesh. 5 new words that you have learned for today.
Revolve.
Revolve. Okay, good.
Hilarious.
Hilarious. How do you spell hilarious, by the way?
H-I-L-A-R-I-O-U-S.
Okay, good. Excellent. Okay, 2 words. So, any more?
Phenomenal, like what you said.
Okay, phenomenal.
Stunning and also cinephile.
Good, excellent. So we learned quite a few words which you can use for your film review or for your speaking, and not just for films only. You can use it in a context in which it is suitable. Okay, thank you. Amir has given to us laughter is the best medicine. Yeah, definitely. Okay, so don't be stressed out too much. Tomorrow you've got school. So I'll see you tomorrow, and thank you for joining the lesson. Thank you, and assalamualaikum. Have a very good evening.
Right, thank you.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you.